previously biometrics was driven by the government and the security angle, and, you know, at the airports, how do you stop the bad guys from coming in? So that was the big picture. Today, the big picture is all about, you know, how can you make mobile commerce take place? And so if you're going to buy things, you know, using your phone, then, you know, how does the e-tailer on the other side know and verify that it is the authorized person, you know, making the transaction? Who is making the transaction? Is it actually a human being that is making the transaction? Because software bots can pretend to be humans and they can go and attack different websites and, you know, make purchases. So it brings in a totally different perspective to biometrics. So we look at what makes an entity human. And we have a project where we say, well, look at the cognitive skills and the communicative skills of that entity, and humans can very easily separate themselves from any software bot. And then you go for the identity of the person. And so how do you identify people when they are in a remote location, that it's not monitored, right? So can it be spoofed? Because if it is not a monitored site, and if you are just checking for face matching, then it's possible for an intruder to come, bring somebody else's photograph, put it in front of the web camera, and, you know, do that masquerading quite easily. So we are looking at all these issues, and these are fascinating issues. You know, how do you tell, you know, what happens when the person's facial expression changes? What happens if you take the picture of a person when they were 15 years old and now you're trying to match them 15 years later? How would the face change over a period of time? What kind of models do you have to predict based on an earlier picture, you know, how the person is going to look 15 years later? So all these are very exciting problems. Also, we recently got involved in a project where they're looking at unconstrained face recognition. And this came off from the Boston Marathon bombing, you know. So many people are taking pictures. Many people had video cameras that day when the bombing happened. And everybody took some piece of that marathon race, right? Now, if you had all that information, could you then tell us, you know, who the bad guy was? So how do you integrate all this, you know, amateur pictures taken? So you can, as you can see, you know, there are so many other interesting aspects to biometrics. And the center that we have is involved with all these aspects. Another recent project which we got funded from the National Science Foundation is what we call continuous authentication, which means that, you know, usually we go and log in at a desktop and, you know, we have our account and we work, and then we can walk away, go to the washroom, come back, chat with, go to the water coolers, chat with friends and come back, and you're still logged in. Maybe they will time you out after 5 minutes or 2 minutes or 10 minutes. But can we do something so that the system is assured that it's the same person all the time that's using that account? So that brings up new challenges. So a whole variety of exciting research problems are out there for us to look at.